Howrah Bridge is one of the longest hanging bridges in India. This is also called as Ravindra Setu. This was commissioned in 1943. Howrah Bridge is not only a popular landmark in Kolkata, it is also a national monument and spectacular tourist attraction. Every day, at least 1 lakh vehicles cross over this bridge. This is a bathing ghat near Howrah station jetty. Lot of people take bath in this holy river. This is a small Shiva temple near the bathing ghat. The devotees worship Lord Shiva after taking bath in the holy river. This bathing ghat is just about 100 meters from the Howrah Bridge, and the bridge is clearly visible from this place. This is the Kali temple in Kalighat. This is a very old temple and considered as very important from the religious point of view. The main deity of the temple is goddess Kali. Apart from Kali, there are temples of Lord Shiva, Ganesh and Hanuman in the temple premises. This is Nakuleshwar Bhairab temple near the Kalighat Kali temple. There is a beautiful Shiva linga in this temple. This is Babu ghat near the Hooghly River. There is a jetty near the Babu ghat and regular ferry services from Babu ghat to Howrah. These are the views of Kolkata city from the boat while going from Babu ghat to Howrah. This is Birla Mandir, located in Ballygunge, which is about 2 kilometers from the Kalighat Kali temple. This is built by the well-known industrialist Birla family. The main deities worshipped in this temple are Laxmi and Narayan. The temple is beautifully carved in white marble. This is Mahanagar Peace Park, located near Victorial Memorial Hall. This is a government park and open free to the public.
Peace Park.
This arch showing the symbols of Ramakrishna Mission is located near the Belur bus stop. From this place, the Belur Math is a short walk of about 200 meters. This is the front side entrance of Belur Math, and this is Ramakrishna Sangraha Mandira, a museum dedicated to Ramakrishna Paramahansa. The Ramakrishna Memorial Temple is also partly visible from here. Photography is strictly prohibited inside Belur Math. I will show you some photographs and videos which we took from the riverside while going from Belur to Dakhineswar by boat. This was the view of Belur Math. There are many temples in Belur Math dedicated to Ramakrishna Paramahansa, Vivekananda and many other saints. This was the bathing ghat at Belur Math. This was the view of Vivekananda Setu, a bridge near Dakhineswar temple. From Belur, we went to Dakhineswar by boat. This is the ferry ghat at Belur. Every 15 minutes, boats go from Belur to Dakhineswar. The boat takes about 15 minutes to reach Dakhineswar. While going by the boat, we could see this beautiful view of Dakhineswar Kali temple. You can also see the bathing ghat here, called as Dakhineswar bathing ghat. From Dakhineswar ferry ghat, we took a short walk to Dakhineswar temple. This was a large pond on the way while going to Dakhineswar temple from the ferry ghat. This was the external main gate to enter into the temple campus. These are the pictures of various temples and structures inside the main campus. These are some of the pictures from inside the campus. There are many temples inside the campus, such as temples of Lord Kali, Shiva, Ganesh and others. Dakhineswar Kali temple is probably the most beautiful temple of Kolkata. It was our great privilege to visit this historical temple. Eden Garden in Kolkata is famous for its cricket stadium. While one part of it is the cricket stadium, the other part of it is a beautiful garden accessible to the general public. There is no ticket or entry fee to enter into this garden. Thank you. The map of the garden is displayed at various places inside the garden. There are different sections of the garden like the water bodies, pagoda, the desert garden, Japanese garden, etc. As we saw, many parts of the garden were under construction and rejuvenation. Though it was a big garden in a big city, we could hardly see any visitor in the garden. Victorial Memorial Hall is a large palatial building in Kolkata. The building is made of white marble, depicting a combination of Mughal and British architecture. The building was inaugurated in 1921 in the memory of Queen Victoria. At the entrance, there is a statue of King Edward VII. There are two artificial lakes at both the sides of the entrance. There is a beautiful garden spread over 64 acres of land. In front of the palace, there is a huge marble statue of Lord Curzon. At the top of the building, there is a 16 feet tall bronze statue of Victory mounted on ball bearings which rotates with the direction of wind.
Okay.
Inside the building, there is a museum of paintings, weapons, and other artifacts of British era. Currently, the visitors are allowed to climb on the first floor, which looks like a dome. Photography is not allowed inside the museum. The building looks different from different angles. It is no doubt one of the most important heritage buildings and most attractive tourist points in Kolkata.
বেশি দূরে গেলে আর ভালো ছিল।
Alipore Zoo is one of the oldest zoos in India, established in 1875. It is spread over 46 acres of land on Alipore Road in Kolkata. This was the den of a tiger. We could see a huge Royal Bengal tiger who was cheered by thousands of spectators.
आया तो
out of the many other attractions in the zoo, the chimpanzee was most interesting for us. It was entertaining the spectators with various types of its funny activities. Millennium Park is located on the eastern banks of River Hooghly. This is a public park and the entry ticket is Rs. 5. The main attractions of Millennium Park are the views of River Hooghly, the views of Howrah Bridge, Vidyasagar Bridge, and the beautiful boats floating on the river. Millennium Park is a beautiful place for spending long time. This place is a paradise for the loving couples. We had a pleasant experience in the Millennium Park.